place where dreams are born and time is never planned. It's not on any chart, you must find it with your heart. Never, never land. It might be miles beyond the moon, or right there where you stand. Just keep an open mind, and then suddenly you'll find, never, never land. You'll have a treasure if you stay there, more precious far than gold. For once you have found your way there, you can never, never grow old. And that's my home, where dreams are born and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart will fly on wings forever.
Die. It will not die. Around that bedpost? Oh yes. Around my neck? Oh dear no.
Won't take a bath, Nana. I won't take a bath.
Go and be bathed at once, sir. Oh look here. There's hair all over my trousers. You clumsy, clumsy dog.
I have a brush oil, Father dear.
Oh thank you. Mother, you know sometimes I think it's a mistake to have a dog for a nurse.
George, you must keep Nana. I will tell you why, my dear. When I came to this room tonight, I saw a face at the window.
A face at that window? Two floors up?
It was a face of a little boy. He was trying to get in.
Impossible.
But wait, the boy was not quite alone. He was accompanied by, I don't know how to describe it, by a ball of light that darted about the room like a living thing.
Well, that is very unusual.
But George, look at all this thing.
Oh my God, look at this dog. Here all over the classroom again. I will not allow this dog in my nursery for 1 minute longer.
Oh, Father, please, Father.
Am I the master of this house, or is he? Come on, Nana. Nice, Nana. Pretty, Nana. Aha, gotcha.
Father, please, Father.
Don't go, please. He's awfully unhappy.
That's not his unhappy bark. That's his bark when he smells danger.
Can anything harm us, Mother, after the eyelight out?
Nothing precious. There's the eye of Mother leave behind the gutter children. Now, say your goodnight, friends, and you're about.
Thank you.
dear Nylite, that protect my sleeping children, Fern Claire and Stephos tonight.
Do you know where they put it? Oh, my shadow. I found you. I'll stick you on with... soap. What's your name?
Wendy Moira Angela Darling. What's your name?
Peter Pan.
Where do you live?
Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
What a funny address.
No, it isn't.
I mean, is that what they put in your letters?
Don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
I don't have a mother. I can't get my shadow to stick on.
It has fallen off. How awful. What must be sewn on? I shall sew it on for you.
Thank you.
Sit right there by the window. I dare say it might hurt a little.
Well, I never cry.
There.
Wendy! Wendy, look! My shadow! Oh, I am clever. Oh, the cleverness of me.
Oh, Peter, you are so clever. Shall I give you a kiss?
Thank you.
Don't you know what a kiss is?
I shall know when you give it to me. Thank you. Now, shall I give you a kiss?
If you please. An acorn. Why, Peter, I shall wear it on this chain around my neck. Peter, how old are you?
I don't know. I ran away from home the day I was born.
Ran away? Why?
Because I heard father and mother talking about what I was to be when I become a man. And I want to always be a little boy and to have fun. So I ran away. And I've lived a long time among the fairies.
You really know fairies?
Yes. But they're nearly all dead now.
Why?
You see, Wendy, when the first baby laughed for the first time, the laugh broke into 1,000 pieces, and they all went skipping about, and that was the beginning of fairies. So now when every new baby is born, its first laugh becomes a fairy, so there ought to be a fairy for every boy or girl.
Ought to be? Isn't there?
Oh no. Children know such a lot now. Soon they don't believe, and every time a child says, "I don't believe in fairies," there's a fairy somewhere that falls down dead.
Poor things.
Can't think of where she's gone to. Tinkerbell! Tink!
Peter, you don't mean to tell me that there's a real-life fairy right here in this room?
She came with me. Wendy, I believe I shut her up in that drawer. Well, you needn't say that. How could I know you were in that drawer?
What does she say?
She's not very polite. Tink, you know you can't be my fairy because I am a gentleman and you're a lady.
It's all right. He's chained up. Peter, where do you live?
Neverland.
What does it look like?
It's an island, and it has hardly any space between one adventure and another.
It sounds lovely. Neverland. Who else lives there?
The Lost Boys.
Who are they?
They're children who fall out of their prams when the nurse is looking the other way. And if they aren't claimed in 7 days, they're sent far away to Neverland. I'm captain.
What fun it must be.
Yes, but we do get rather lonely. And none of us know any stories.
How perfectly awful.
Wendy, your mother was telling you such a lovely story. The story about the prince, and he couldn't find the lady who wore the glass slipper.
Oh, that's Cinderella. Peter, he found her and they lived happily ever after.
I'm glad.
Where are you going?
To tell the Lost Boys.
Don't go, Peter. I know lots of stories.
Do you?
Oh, Peter, the stories I could tell the boys.
Well, come on. We'll fly.
Fly? You can fly?
Wendy, come with me. How we should all respect you.
Will you teach John and Michael to fly too?
If you like.
John, Michael, wake up. There's a boy here who is going to teach us how to fly.
There is?
Then I'll get up at once. Someone's coming out the light.
Dog.
All clear.
Can you really fly?
I'll teach you.
And how do you do it?
You just think lovely, wonderful thoughts. And up you go.
Oh, how sweet.
I'm flying.
Christmas?
That's it! Off to Neverland!
Maybe he's going to be
Cinderella.
Bloody buccaneers and each a murderer's drunk. You capture the girls and trap little boys and cater to Captain Hook.
Tiger Lily's brave girls upon us.
Captain, shall I have
to? Not now, Smee. He's only one. I want to mischief all of them. They must live around here somewhere. Scatter and search for them. Most of all, I want their captain, Peter Pan. 'Twas he that cut off me arm. Oh, I waited long to shake hands with him. With this!
Yes, I've often heard that you say your hook was worth a score of hands. Four for combing the hair, another homely uses.
Aye, Smee. If I were a mother, I would pray for my children to be born with this instead of that. But Pan flung me hand to the crocodile that happened to be passing by.
I have often noticed a strange dread of crocodiles.
Not of crocodiles, Smee, but of one crocodile. He likes me hand so much he's followed me ever since, from land to land, from sea to sea, following ship, licking his lips with the rest of me.
Oh. You know what, Captain? In a way, it's sort of a compliment.
Well, I want no such compliments, Smee! He would have gone me long ere, and he could have crept upon me unawares. But, by some lucky chance, he spotted a clock.
A clock!
And it goes on, tick, tock, tick, within him. And so before he could reach me, oh, I hear the tick.
Captain, someday will the clock run down and he'll get you.
Aye, Smee, that is a fear that haunts me. Oh, oh, oh. Wait. Smee!
Oh, what's the matter, Captain?
Smee, this seat is hot! Oh, it's very hot! Oh, this bomb's having a tug! Smee, help me! Wait a minute. That chimney! Peter and the boys must be living underground.
Oh, Captain, listen!
Call back the band!
Come back here!
They say Pan's away from home. I must think. Inspire me!
What tempo, Captain?
Tempo. A tango!
Tango!
Unrip your plan, Captain!
To cook a cake quite large, you should each layer in between. With icing mixed with poison. Till it turns a tempting green. We'll place it near the house, just where the boys are sure to come. And being greedy, they won't care to question such a plum.
And the boys who had no mother sweet want to show their mistake won't know it's dangerous to eat so damp and rich a cake. And so before the winking of an eye, those boys will eat that poison cake, and one by one they'll die.
Hooray! Bravo, Captain, bravo, that was fantastic.
Forward, little boys, the time has come. Wait! Smee the crook! Smee the crook!
How do you know, Captain?
I can hear the ticking! Oh.
much noise. Listen to Tiger Lily. Shh. Wugga wugga hee haw! Omen. Famous brave girl proverb, when in doubt, run! Great surprise.
So do we! And
what?
Wendy! With an arrow in her heart? This is not a bird. It is a lady.
A lady?
I was bringing her here to be our mother, and you have killed her.
Her arm! She lives!
Look, the arrow. It struck against this. It's a kiss I gave her.
I remember kissing. Yeah, that is a kiss.
Are you asleep, Wendy? Don't you want to get up and play?
What shall we do with her?
Maybe we should bring her
down. No. We must not touch her. That wouldn't be sufficiently respectful. I know. We'll build a house around her. I have a plan. Let's be quiet as a mouse and build a lovely little house for Wendy. All for Wendy. She's come to stay. Make us pockets and sing to us, tell us stories we've been longing to hear. Over and over, she'll be waiting at the door. We won't be lonely anymore since Wendy. Have a mother, Wendy's here to say.
be your mother, provided Peter will be the father.
All right, as long as it's only make-believe.
Yay!
Children, I'm sure this cake is much too damp and rich for you.
Aww.
Now go wash up. It's your bedtime.
The game is up. The boys have found the mother.
What's the mother, Captain?
Tis, I must think.
What's up?
A tarantella.
Tarantella.
Methinks I see a spark, a gleam, a glimmer of a plan, for which perhaps I may redeem me honor as a man. Kidnap Wendy, seize the boys, and you'll have hope to thank, for when the time is right, you'll see the children walk the plank. A princely cock concocted by another to murder all the boys and keep the Wendy for her mother.
Oh!
A princely cock concocted by another to murder all the boys and keep the Wendy for her mother!
Yo ho! Yo ho!
Yo ho!
Yo ho!
Yo ho!
Yo ho!
To the ship! To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship!
To the ship! To the ship!
Are you all ready for today's lesson?
Yes, Peter!
Then all of you, listen to your teacher. Repeat after me. I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
I'd want to go to school.
I want to go to school.
Just to learn to be a parrot.
Just to learn to be a parrot.
And recite a silly rule.
And recite a silly rule.
If growing up means it would be beneath my dignity to climb a tree, I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up. Not me.
Not us.
Not me.
Not me.
I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
Not a penny will I pinch.
Not a penny will I pinch.
I will never grow a mustache.
I'll never grow a mustache.
For a fraction of an inch.
For a fraction of an inch.
'Cause growing up is awfuler than all the awful things that ever.
Move! The captain ordered us to tie her to the tree and leave her here for the wolves!
Poor Tiger Lily! Ahoy there, you lover!
It is the captain!
I tie Tiger Lily to the tree, Captain!
Set her free!
Set her free?
Cut her bonds now, or I will plunge me hook in you!
Better do as the captain orders!
Aye, aye, Captain!
It's Hook. He followed us here. We're trapped. Follow me.
is the captain.
Captain is all well.
All is well. Where is Tiger Lily?
That, Captain. It's all right, we let her go.
You let her go?
Aye, 'twas her own orders.
You called us to let her go.
Brimstone and gall, what cozening is here?
Kaka!
Peter Pan!
Stars.
Yes, I know. Come on, let's make two tribes into one.
Yeah.
Ugwug, 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 wah.
Ugwug, 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 ugwug,
wah. Gugabug, 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 wah. Ugwug, 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 ugwug. When we get in trouble, ugwug. I'll just send for Tiger Lily.
I'll send for Peter Pan.
We'll be coming willy nilly. Lily, beat on a drum. And I will come. And I will come and save the strong, noble, brave girl. Ugwa, 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 ugwa. Ugwa, 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 ugwa. Ugwa, 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 ugwa.
Ibbity, bibbity, ibbity, bibbity, zap.
Ibbity, bibbity, ibbity, bibbity, zap. Only pretend, isn't it, that I'm their father?
Well, yes, but they're ours, Peter, yours and mine.
But not really?
Not if you don't want it to be.
I don't.
But I'm ready for them, Mom.
Peter, shall we sing them a lullaby? Father will adopt you all.
All right.
Yay!
Now put away your beds and get ready. Peter, I'm gonna give you your medicine before your journey.
I'm not going with you, Wendy.
Yes, Peter.
No.
Why not?
I don't want to grow up and learn about solemn things. I want to always be little boy and to have fun, and no one is going to catch me and make me a man.
Peter isn't coming.
Peter's not coming?
Then Peter, we won't leave you.
Now then, no fuss, no blubbering. Just say goodbye. Over. Who won? If the brave girls have won, they will beat the drum. Just listen. The drum. It's a brave girl victory. You're safe now, Wendy. Tiger Lily will escort you through the forest. Lead the way, Tink. Goodbye, boys.
Peter, this is your medicine, you know.
I won't forget it.
Peter, if you'll come for me once a year, I'll do your spring cleaning. Will you come?
If you like.
You won't forget? Peter, oh Peter, how I wish I could take you up and squeeze you.
Wendy, here. This is for you.
Thank you.
Tell them, the men, to take them to the ship. The boys, we will make walk the plank, and Wendy will be our mother.
What about Peter, Captain?
This is for Peter.
Poison!
Aye, he's doomed.
Thank you.
Tink? Wendy and the boys have been captured by the pirates. I'll rescue her. What? Oh, that's just my medicine. Poisoned? Nonsense. Who could have poisoned it? I promised Wendy to take it, and I'm going to. Why, Tink? You've drunk my medicine! What's the matter with you? It was poisoned. You drank it to save my life! Tink, dear Tink. Your light is growing faint, and if it goes out, that means you're dead. You say you could get well if children believed in fairies. Do you believe? Oh, please, please believe wherever you are. If you believe, clap your hands and she'll hear you. Please, please, don't let Tink die. Keep clapping. Oh, please, please believe, all of you. Keep clapping. Don't let her die. Her life's getting stronger. Her life's getting stronger. Keep clapping. She's getting better. Oh, thank you. She's all right now. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. Thank you. Come on, Tink. Let's go save Wendy.
How still the night is. Nothing sounds alive. Now is when children are in their homes abed, with their lips bright brown with the good night chocolate, and their tongues drowsily searching for the belated crumbs housed insecurely on their shiny cheeks. Compare them to the children captive on this boat. Split me the infinitives. Tiss me hour of triumph. I have reached me peak. I am the greatest villain of all time. Brit, call back the band. Come back here.
The swiniest wine in the world.
Captain Hook! Captain Hook!
Who's the dirtiest dog in this wonderful world?
Captain Hook! Captain Hook!
Captain of villainy, murder and loot. Eager to kill any who says that his hook isn't cute. Who's the slimiest rat in the pack?
Captain Hook! Captain Hook!
Who's unlovable? Who's unlivable? Whose existence is infinitely favorable? Who would stoop to the lowest and cheapest of tricks in the book?
Tricks in the book!
Fly me, Captain Hook! Who's the swiniest?
The swiniest!
The doggiest?
The doggiest!
The slimiest!
The slimiest!
The prettiest creep in the world!
Captain Hook! Captain Hook!
Who's unsensible?
You!
Reprehensible?
You!
Behavior is just indefensible!
Are all the prisoners chained?
Aye, the captain, the little birds are.
Then hoist them up. Now, you bullies, you are about to walk the plank. But I have room for two cabin boys. Which of it, you, is it going to be? Stow your gab! You boy! You look as if you had a little pluck in you. Did this ever dream of becoming a pirate, me hearty?
What would you call me if I joined?
Blackbeard Joe.
You're still confessing to black.
You must swear down with the flag!
Down with the flag!
Then I refuse!
Well, that seals your fate. Bring them, Mother!
Wendy!
Now, me proud beauty, you're about to see your children walk the plank.
Are they to die?
They are. Silence! Silence all for her mother's last words to her sons. Smee! Smee, I hear the clock! Smee, Smee!
Oh, Captain! The croc is gone. There's not a sound.
Oh, Captain, the ship's bewitched!
The ship's bewitched. There's a Jonah aboard.
It's Peter Pan, the Avenger.
Oh, Pan, this is all your doing.
It is all my doing.
Young and impotent youth, prepare to meet thy doom.
You dark and sinister man, have it!
And what art thou?
I am youth. I am joy. I am freedom.
If I am to die, then you'll all die with me. In 2 minutes, the ship will be blown to pieces. Back, Billy's mom. Back. I'll show you the road to dusty death. The croc! Back! The croc! No! It's coming! I can't! Oh no! Ah! Oh! No! 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 Wait! Pan! I cannot express my utter contempt for you! Continue! Ah! 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 No! No! Save me! No!
Peter Pan is the bravest and strongest of all boys. Yes, I know. I don't say it to brag. It's because I just can't tell a lie.
I got him, bro.
Time for later.
John!
Mother!
Mother!
A little less noise there, please. A little less noise.
Father!
Wendy, Michael, John! Oh, who are they?
There are a few more of us. Won't you adopt them?
All of them?
Please, Father.
George, don't you think you'll manage? Well, what's another 1, 3, 4, 5, 7? What's another 14 more?
We'll be our children!
Well then, make yourself a home.
Yeah! Peter, don't forget to come for me once a year. Please, please don't forget.
Thank you.
It's almost like you've done this before.
We have!
Thank you. Once more. Once more. Once more.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. He sprinkled me in pixie dust and told me to believe, believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly away in a cloud of green to your beautiful destiny. As we soared above the town that never loved me, I realized I finally had a family. Soon enough we reach Neverland, peacefully my feet hit the sand. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you are my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are now my home sweet home forever, a lost boy at last. Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you are my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are now my home sweet home forever, a lost boy at last. And for always I will sing, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland's home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland's home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free.
Forget, don't be slow, ready, set, here we go. Wendy, Michael, come on, Tinkerbell, come on. Hurry up and follow me, for I'll soon be gone.
I can be. I must be a sight lovely to see.
Tiger Lily.
Today's lesson?
Yes, Peter!
Then all of you listen to your teacher and repeat after me.
I won't grow up.
I don't want to go to school.
Just learn to be a parrot.
And recite a silly rule.
If growing up means it would be beneath my dignity to climb up a tree, I'll never grow up.
Not me.
I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
Not a penny roll a hedge.
I will never grow a mustache.
Or a fraction of an inch.
Cause growing up means awfuler than all the awful things that ever.
Into one.
A
ugh, 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 ug